Hi, I'm Tess Woolcock and welcome to a special edition of Ten's Weird News. Today I'm joined in the studio by Erik Sprague, better known as Lizard Man. He's had a whole lot of body modification to look like a lizard and he joins me now. Hi Erik, thanks for coming in. First of all, why did you decide you wanted to become a lizard?
Well, it started off when I was about 18 years old. I went to college and I was studying art and philosophy. And I had already been working, you know, in terms of sort of student art projects throughout high school with temporary modifications, things like body painting and costuming. And I wanted to do something more permanent. You know, I was developing and evolving as an artist, and I was also getting interested and involved with body modification. So I decided I wanted to use that in terms of my artwork.
Why a lizard, though? Did a dinosaur or a turtle just not do it for you?
Just a pure aesthetic choice. I like the way that reptiles look. The same way you might pick out an outfit for the day, you pick out something you think looks good. I thought this looked good.
Okay, so talk me through the procedures you've had done.
I'll give you the grocery list, as it were. 700 hours of tattooing covers my entire body, top to bottom, head to toe, face included. Subdermal Teflon implants on my skull to create the horned ridges over my eyes. Teeth filed down to sharp points using a dentist drill. And, of course, a bifurcated tongue, split in two like that of a snake using an argon biopsy laser.
Oh, could you do that straight away?
When it was first done, immediately after the procedure, my tongues were so swollen, I couldn't really do anything. So it was about 48 hours of time where I was just, you know, putting ice chips on my mouth and waiting for the pain to go away and the swelling to subside. But after about a week, I could talk and eat pretty normally. 4 to 6 weeks, probably, more or less fully healed.
Out of all of them, what's hurt the most?
The most painful thing that I've done in terms of body modification is easily my implants. So bad that I actually hallucinated and vomited as a result of the pain.
You must have a pretty strong pain threshold.
I think that, you know, I've over the years become very good at coping with pain. I often say, if I know something is going to happen, I can prepare myself and handle just about anything. But if it's a surprise, like if I stub my toe, I cry like a little girl.
What does your family think?
Well, my family's reaction is going to be different than anybody else's because they have the perspective. You know, especially my mom and dad, they've seen me from, you know, day one till now. My mom has actually said that it would be stranger if I wasn't Lizard Man because she sees the progression. But for a lot of people, that isn't there. You know, they just see me wandering down the street and they're like, what is that and how did it happen?
What if you woke up one day and you were just sick of being Lizard Man and you decided you wanted a normal job?
I don't think I'll ever want a normal job. In fact, a big part of the appeal of this to me is that a lot of normal jobs are out of reach. You know, people will say, well, you never get a job working at a bank looking at it. I'm like, well, thank you, because I'd never want to be stuck working in a bank behind a counter as a teller or something like that. But, you know, there are no guarantees in life for any of us. You know, as much as I could regret in the future being Lizard Man, you could regret being a reporter, being on TV. Anyone can regret anything. The way that we diminish the possibility of regret is by careful planning in the beginning. And I did spend over 3 years planning and considering this. That's more time than most people put into getting to know the person they marry and have kids with.
Okay, so you're actually here in Australia promoting a book. Do you want to tell me a little bit about that?
Right. This is the new Ripley's annual, Download the Weird. I have been working with Ripley's for about 13 years now, going back to when they revived the TV show, the series that was hosted by Dean Cain. And since then, I've worked with the museums and now the books over the last few years.
What's weird to you?
Normal people are weird. Quote, unquote, normal people are very weird to me.
And finally, how much did all this cost?
Asking how much it cost to me is kind of like going to a gallery, looking at a painting and saying, wow, look at that masterpiece. How much did the paint and the canvas cost? It's not really a relevant question. That said, about 8 or 9 years ago, I was doing a television program, and they thought it would be interesting to get an insurance adjuster, sort of that it wasn't Lloyd's of London, but one of those types of groups that, you know, insured dancers' legs and things like that. So they brought the guy out, they had him talk to me, look at what I'd done. They said, all right, how much would you insure Lizard Man for? And his response was no less than $250,000.
Now you inside the world of Sideshow Wonderland, where you will witness acts like the human blockhead, the cranial corkscrew, and a demonstration of fierce weightlifting that cannot be believed if you do not see it with your own eyes. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Come on inside. The money you spend on the ticket, you will soon forget.
And that's it from this weird new special. I'm Tess Woolcock, and I'll be back later in the week with plenty more strange stuff.